But is checking out other areas that match up with this. Hi, Karnak. Thanks for stopping by as I stumble and fumble my way through this. This one. Oh, are you the one who alerted me to the fact I forgot to save my game after fighting a boss? Oh, thank you on that. I kept wondering why I had one too many jewels. Why is that turtle walking on nothingness? Maybe that's a clue. let's see. That is on the this side, down below. So I'm assuming you've played this game quite through and through. Did that go the right way? No, it's on the other side. Or what? I was just here and I've already forgotten the layout of this entire area. Okay, it's down below. A randomizer for this game. Sounds like an extreme challenge to me. I can imagine. So it's interesting, this... I don't think this enemy spawns when I'm in the other... Oh, is this not even the same room? Oh. Maybe that was just a fluke. Tablet in a pot. Okay. I'm uncovering new mysteries. Okay, it is the room. Probably because I attacked it. Why is it? Okay. I don't know if this necessarily helps me, but... Yeah, it needs to give me a ceiling so that I can't jump through and get up there. That makes sense. Yeah, it could be two different screens because there's no... whatever that Abawaku enemy is. It's just kind of different data, I guess. Now let's try wandering around in the ice area again. Just to see if anything is new. Feeling there's another piece of the ground somewhere I need to break through to get into that area. Don't want to accidentally anger an eyeball. Nope. So there is the suspicious block down below that looks like a pressure plate and just crumbles when I touch it. I wonder if that might lead somewhere. I might visit there later. Probably should have just warped. Oh, I'm still exploring. Oh. Oh, the Spalder was 100% me getting the fairy with the key and stumbling upon it. Can't do anything with this. Yeah, no hints needed, just in-game cheats. Okay, so I have an idea. I don't know if this is a good idea, but it's an idea nonetheless. But I need bullets. So about 30 hours in, I realize that the attacking fairy uses whatever weapon you have equipped, not just something random. So if I equip the gun, is the attack fairy going to shoot the swarm of flying enemies in the Tower of Ruin? Yeah, I did. It took me a little while to figure out the fake orb and the fake red jewel were traps and not just like mysterious items that I don't know what was going on because I didn't recognize them at first. Oh, this is new, is it? This is ammunition. One bullet? Okay. Better not use that accidentally. So I need to... Okay. There's some expensive bullets. I want to go back to here. And then up here. And then down here, and then back up here. And then try to get the attack fairy. Nope, that's the Key Fairy, but... Where should I try to use this? Let's try here. Anytime you want to find a secret, it's just fine with me. Okay. A distinct feeling I'm putting this to waste. Warp back here. No? Where am I going? Randomly try somewhere else. So this is a room where I want to shoot down everything. Okay, so I'm assuming that means I would have needed the golden key. So, what does this even do? Okay, we have a hidden shop. What is that shopkeep? Looks like a brain in a tub. Snapshots. Make a few notes here. And what does the software do for me? Okay. I can think of one mural to use that on. Need more RAM. I guess I don't really need that combo. So I want to go into the dark thing, Chamber of Extinction. can just warp there. Okay, well that was not as useful as I thought it was going to be. So wait, what does this do again? Oh, I have a camera now. So maybe this is useful elsewhere. Yeah. There is one that I want to check from here. Since I'm down here. So, originally not the greatest impression that it grew on you. Oh, sorry, I just realized that there's two people in chat because you're both purple and I'm not paying attention, so hi, communists. Oh, why am I mashing the attack button? Nothing hidden up there. It's like, who's... Are they talking to me? What? Okay. Where else can I explore? Okay. Back to plan B number 35. Trying to shoot down a bunch of those enemies with the attack fairy, which may or may not have respawned by now. Thank you for making your name color different, Karnak. I'd say I had a similar hate turn into love experience with a game when I bought the original Demon's Souls back when it got released. And I played and played, and I got about 9 hours in and still hadn't figured out how to level up or really play well, and I had thought I'd made a huge mistake buying this game, but at a certain moment it just kind of clicked, and I've enjoyed this series ever since. I don't even remember which fairy that was. I think that was going to be the treasure fairy. This is the attack fairy, right? Okay. See what happens. Doesn't seem to do anything. So the problem is the flares don't attack high enough. So that's why I was hoping she would suddenly whip out a revolver and start gunning everybody down, but that doesn't seem to be the case. Unless I need a reload. She does not use guns. If it weren't for two of those enemies, yeah, I don't know if any of you saw this, but I kept wandering into the one mini boss fight with this fairy and wondering why she kept attacking into objects that instantly got me zapped, but at least now I understand how it works. So hopefully that won't happen too many more times. Oh, that's a bad choice. There goes that idea. So maybe I need to start way from the beginning and keep my eye out for murals. There's a few in the Gate of Guidance. Oh, maybe I should check with the elder real quick. Ain't that the truth? Low coast, obviously, there is the mural down here. And there's a distinct possibility that I've gotten this much earlier than I should have, and it's not useful yet. But who knows? Okay, got a raid coming in from Klebs. Hi Klebs. Hi 1L, hi 1, or Dr. Sniffles. Hi Trap Shot. Welcome in everybody. Let's see if I can get over here. Hi Lady Cat. I'm guessing Klebs victoriously defeated Mylan's secret castle. Thank you for hauling, Lady Cat. Nice. Thanks for the follow, Trap Shot and Lady Cat. So did you beat it deathless, or is that going to be running in the future? Thank you, Dr. Sniffles. let's see. Well, now it's finally over and you don't have to play it again until somebody else suggests it. Oh, that was not smart. So... hold on here. See if I can do this right. If you've not seen Klebs before, okay. All sorts of weird stuff going on with Streamlabs. You should check Klebs out sometime. He's an awesome guy. It's... La-Mulana is going okay. I don't quite know where I'm supposed to be going yet, which is about 50 to 70% of my playtime. I've acquired a bunch of things, but I have a bunch of statues that are blocking my path, which maybe I should check now that I have the scanning ability. So there's these giant statues blocking my path. You can see on the right. There's a little pathway down and a ladder. But I don't know exactly how to get through here. The giant eyeball up in the ceiling will attack me if I try to attack the statue. there is a clue in this area that the statues are illusions, but they seem pretty solid because I can't walk through them. Oh, it's gonna send me down. What am I doing? Got this mysterious room here with what look like passageways, but I can't go through them. This kind of looks like it could have been a door, but I can't do anything up there. Mysterious room hidden inside a statue with nothing inside, and background music from a different area. And I can't do anything else in here. So just non-stop mysteries. Oh, and my attack is not as strong because I've been messing with my software. There are mysterious triangle reliefs in the background that are... Oops. These Eyes of Truth. And I've picked up the Eye of Truth, but it doesn't seem to be... Oh, how many hours? 30 plus, I would say. Definitely over 30 hours. And I feel like I'm maybe 50% or slightly more of the way through the game just by the amount of stuff I've collected and bosses I've defeated. And I just recently... Well, it's... I think the length of the game is highly dependent on how well you can solve its riddles. And there's definitely things that I've solved on accident that did appear like I would have figured out that answer with the clues the game provided me, so it wasn't just a complete fluke. So all the rooms with these statues blocking my paths have these lights illuminating the statues. And I thought maybe there's something I can do to put out the light, but I can't seem to do anything. Haven't quite figured out what's going on with this little trap over here. Because no matter how fast I get into the room, I cannot get into there. And I think there's a certain degree of you can do things slightly out of order. So I think I might have fought a few bosses when I was a little underpowered and it took me longer than it should have. Like especially a giant fish boss. How do I get out of here? I think I flip through here. It's easier. I probably should just... yeah, the full Bahamut experience. Probably don't need the map. Not enough memory. Don't need email. Okay, so that apparently makes me stronger. But I no longer have access to the map. Oops, what am I doing? Oh yeah, I have a clock there in the upper right. 35 hours, 17 minutes, and counting. Oh, and a few... that was an interesting moonwalking dog, or whatever that thing is. If you have a chance to look at the... There's like a PDF manual for this game. And it's a little bit spoilery, but it's got some really cool illustrations in it that I just checked out very recently. I'm guessing it was for the original PC release, or maybe... I think maybe there was some kind of physical release of this too, although I'm playing a downloaded version. Oh, whoops. Wasn't paying attention. So, yeah, you don't want to attack various sacred objects in rooms that have those giant eyeballs. It's just kind of a, I think a... preventing you from attacking willy-nilly and solving things that you need to think more carefully about. Where do I want to check? What would have a mural? Let's check the... Well, let's check in with... Mulbrook. See if she has any sage advice for me. Yeah, she's busy sleeping. Okay, so there's this room filled with deadly poison gas. And I think I need to do something with this statue on the left. But I cannot seem to figure it out. I'm supposed to reveal light to it. I tried shooting a flare at it, which didn't seem to count. And I have a feeling I need to fight some kind of... boss or mini boss. But I don't know how to get to large portions of various maps. I think part of it must be I need to figure out how to get rid of those giant goddess statues. But I don't have a clue yet how to do that. Any other room that would have a mural? What was the other way in here from... the Inferno? Is it here? No, that's the Tower of Ruin. So the Eye of Truth appears to be kind of a dud because I don't know what it's referring to. And there's these tablets that are blank, and I thought it might help with those. There's nothing I can read on those. There's pretty clearly a mini boss nearby. Because there's the room that I fell into has a crucifix. Which looks... where's the note? This mentions a mystery between murals, but I need the golden key, which I don't have. So this pretty clearly matches up with this room, and there's something on the left, but I don't dare attack anything, else that eye in the sky is going to murder me. And then one area I haven't checked yet, I will visit briefly, is the I can't warp there. Chamber of Confusion, or whatever it's called. How do I warp there? And I have about 5 to 10 maps open at any given time with all sorts of notes that I should have wrote better notes on as I went through the game. Gate of Illusion. So will the Eye of Truth help me in any way in the Gate of Illusion? Moonlight Temple. Temple of Moonlight. If I go up here, I enter a very confusing area with all sorts of mysterious warps and hidden paths and whatnot. So I'm going to take a picture of everything in here, just in case. Still haven't figured out which menu button is which. Entirely possible. I'm not supposed to be using this for this, but couldn't hurt to check. And I can't get there from here. So I need to warp down here. Into this doorway because it's on the ceiling. Trying not to die to the spikes on my way down. And then how do I this is a warp. And do I go here? So the warps don't necessarily match up back to forward. Oh, here we go, upper level. Because even though there is a warp to the left here, I want to go down here. And then this warp. And then you can get through here. And I really want to go down, but I can't figure out a way down through there. There's this, whatever this thing is. And whatever that thing is. And whatever this thing is, there's a reverse waterfall that I cannot get through. If I could sink through it somehow, I would be able to progress to other areas. And then there's a mysterious fellow in here who wants me to use pepper on a giant face. Wherever that may be.